Hey guys, it's Haffina, I'm back again, and this is going to be my nail art tutorial for the 1 month, one Sailor Senshi for October, which I believe is Sailor Neptune. And the colours are seafoam, green, and teal. So what I have already done and let dry properly is put on three coats. Yes, three. This is not the best nail polish. Considering it's in full colours, and it's in full colours is usually pretty good. This is from the Kylie Jenner Trend Matters collection, and this is cool as a cucumber. Really like the colour. It's a really nice seafoamy green colour to my mind. It's just not the best quality. I had this idea originally, but it is not going to work because I was going to use this, which I'm still going to use, for my teal, which is Ocean from L'Oreal, from one of their double-ended thingy watsits. It sort of has a thing that joins them together like this, and it came with like a top coat, and the top coat used to be basically a light colour of this, like a clear greenish colour, but something has happened and it is now basically clear, which is a little annoying. So what I was going to do, I won't be doing. However, I'll wing it a little bit, but I will be doing something slightly different. I will be doing something with dotting tools, yes. The original idea I had was a bit more complicated and not really basic kind of manicure. This is going to be a bit more basic, so anybody should be able to do some like this. I've done a similar technique before. I have three different dotting tools here. They came from a set of five. You can pick them up pretty much anywhere. So you'd be using that. I have a little green bow sitting over here on the side that is... is it in the camera? No, it is not. There it is. That is the closest I have to either seafoam green or teal. I could paint it, but I'm not going to. So I'm going to be using that. I'm also going to try something with this glitter here. It may not work. Generally I use this with like gels, but we will see. We are going to experiment a little. So for that I have a sponge tip applicator. That's what they're good for. I also have a plastic bag because I don't have a stamping scraper near me, which is what I normally use. This I'm basically using as a palette. You put your nail polish on it, and when it's dry, you peel it off and throw away the nail polish and keep the little baggie. So if you have lots of little baggies like this, I know Omnea does, they make really good palettes for nail art. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to try this experiment thing with the glitter and see if it works. So I'm going to put a coat of this polish that doesn't work properly, because it's basically clear. I'm going to put a coat of that on my pointer finger. The brush looks a bit messed up, but it still sort of applies the weird polish. I don't know what happened to this polish, it's just very strange. Very, very strange. So as I do this nail art tutorial, I am a week and a half out from my wedding, and, you know, just stressing a little bit. So I'm trying to get videos filmed and edited and ready to go. So we have the glitter. I'm going to take a clean part of the sponge tip applicator. I've used it before, clearly. Just dip it in my glitter. You can't really see what I'm doing. I'm trying to get it in the camera and see what I'm doing. So just dipping it in there. And then I'm just going to press it into the wet polish. Now, normally you would use this kind of product. This is one of them chromy type of powders, sort of holographic. Normally you would use it with a no wipe top coat and buff it in. But you can do it this way, and it will work with regular polish. It's just not as spectacular, and you need to be a little bit more patient. So what I do is I just make sure that I cover the nail pretty well, because you're not going to get a chance to go back and put any more on. And just make sure that it's all pressed in really well. Then put the lid on the glitter so that you don't make a mess. Super duper important. It's really funny, I've got heaps of it, but I don't like wasting it. I'm just weird like that. This one came from Born Pretty, in case you were wondering. And I know a lot of people have problems with Born Pretty, but I'm not one of them. So I recommend Born Pretty, and especially now that they have a US warehouse. It doesn't take anywhere near as long as it used to for stuff to get to the US. Okay, so on our plastic baggy thingy, I'm going to put out some of this teal polish. And I'm going to grab the biggest of the dotting tools and brush the glitter off those nails. Okay. Now I'm just going to put dots, sort of random. And it doesn't matter if they kind of touch. Basically, I'm just going to do that on that now. And I'm going to put some on this now, but in a different location. There's really no rhyme or reason to how you do this. This is just a way that you can spruce up a basic manicure and make it look a little bit different. You can change the size of your dots, put smaller ones in. It's really up to you. I mean, it's your nail, do what you want. And then I'm going to take some of the Akali one. Down as well. It actually has sparkles in it. It does dry matte though. I'm going to use a different stamping tool, dotting tool, and I'm going to go between dots. Just like that. It's not difficult. Put them wherever you want to put them. And this finger appears to be at the point that I want it to be at now. So, fan brush. See where I did not get nail polish properly, because it hasn't stuck. Let's brush off the excess. And kind of worked. Not 100%, but it's kind of worked. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to do it again. See if I can't actually cover the nail properly this time. And then I'm actually going to do it on the little finger as well, for shits and giggles. So basically we have two completely different manicures here, which you guys don't care about. I never was one for having the same thing on all of my nails. We're just going to let everything dry, and then we're going to come back. So, let's see if this worked a little bit better. Yep. Still got some patchy bits in it, but that's kind of to be expected because of the nail polish that I use. It isn't very good quality, obviously, or there's something wrong with it. Rubbing the nail. It helps to get some of the extra bits off. And I'm sort of trying to get it to help some of the glitters lie down in one direction, which helps with your look a little bit. It's not going to work 100%, and it's part of the reason I do these is so that you can see that things don't always work out for me the way I envision them in my head. In fact, it happens to me far more often than I would like to admit. So, what we're going to do now is we're going to top coat. Now, I'm actually going to top coat the middle two nails in a matte top coat to keep them matte, and I'm going to put a shiny glossy top coat on the glittery ones. I'm going to use Sesh Feet on the glittery ones. I've just refilled my bottle. It was starting to look a little thick and gluggy, but I have a little tip for you people who might like to have a matte nail that lasts. One of the biggest problems with matte polishes is that they tend to chip a lot faster than a shiny finish. So what you do is if you want it to be matte and last, you actually top it with a quick dry shiny top coat like Sesh Feet or HK Girl, or any one of those, whatever is your preferred quick dry top coat. So top the nail with that first and give it a chance to dry, and then when it's dry, Then put on your layer of matte top coat. It might seem counterintuitive because you're like, you want me to make it shiny and then make it matte? Well, yeah, because that actually, it actually will last longer. So if you actually want it to last, that's what you should do, is put a shiny quick dry top coat on first, let it dry, and then put your matte top coat on top of that. That is today's lesson. But I'm not going to do that because I'm not planning on wearing these for very long, because I don't generally wear them for very long. So I'm actually going to use two different matte top coats. My favourite matte top, well, the matte top coat that I was using the most. I'm shaking a bottle of polish at the moment, by the way, if you're wondering what that noise is. Is the Sally Hansen Big Matte, and I basically had finished the bottle. And whilst I was waiting for these nails to dry, I had a little accident and a bottle of polish fell off a shelf. And it hit a bottle of glow-in-the-dark nail polish that I actually have. And cracked the bottle of glow-in-the-dark nail polish. Like, it's a topper, like top coat. And so I basically just put the damaged polish into the stuff from the damaged polish bottle into that bottle when it was nearly empty. So now it's glow-in-the-dark matte top coat. It's probably not matte anymore. So the first one I'm going to put on one fingernail. This is the BYS one. I don't remember how good this is. It's probably not very good. Yep, did a great job painting that now. And the other one I'm going to use is, it's sort of matte, but not really matte, is the China Glaze Patent Leather Top Coat. I have like four China Glaze Top Coats. I have quite a few of them. And I was just looking and I realised I have a different matte top coat I could have tried, but nevertheless. So one should give a matte finish and the other should give a finish that looks a little bit like leather. So on my ring finger, because that's what I normally do, I'm going to put this little, you know, because this is a Sailor Moon one and we have to remember our little bow, because that's what I've done on all of them. Shove the bow there before the polish finishes drying. And do a quick... The other problem with glitters is that they tend to be kind of messy. They make a mess on your nails. Interestingly enough, this China Glaze one doesn't appear to be drying in the finish that I was expecting. This one is starting to go matte. But I will take a picture with them fully dry and insert it at the end anyway. So that is it for this video. Everybody else who is doing the Wonder Month One Sailor Senshi will be listed down below. Make sure you go and check them out. And I will see you in my next video. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more content from me, and click the little bell button to get notified. And leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments. See ya!